Hey guys, so let's jump right into it. I'm going to be using my Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade, as always, in the shade Ebony. And I'm going to start to shape my brows because, you know, shorty done got out brows. Okay. By the way, guys, I don't know why, but I end up always going back to this pomade. No matter what I do, I just end up going back to it. I love it so much. Like, yes. Next, I'm taking my NYX Correct Conceal and Contour Palette in Light. You know, I always use this to carve out my brows. It is my favorite thing. I don't know, it's just creamy, it's thick, and it's just perfect for carving out your brows. As you can see, it makes me happy. It makes me dance, yes. I'm going to be setting that with my Anastasia Beverly Hills Clear Brow Gel. And then I'm going in with my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in Fair, and I'm going to use that as an eyeshadow base and also to conceal any veins I have on my eyes. I like to set it, so after I do this, I am going to use my Rimmel Matte Stay Matte Powder in Translucent, and I'm going to set that so my eyeshadows will be better to blend. Then I'm taking the Kat Von D Metal Matte Palette, and I'm going to be using that light shade. I do not know the name. If you have it, look at it. I don't know. Then I'm going to be taking this purpley kind of shade and I'm going to put that in my crease as well. I'm starting to create my cut crease because, you know, I love cut creases. Then I'm going to take this kind of like vampy dark purple shade and I'm going to also put that in my crease. I'm going to work that in. And I'm using an e.l.f. blending brush for this. Then I'm going to switch back to the Anastasia blending brush and I'm going to use that to blend it all out. This is not shown on camera, but I do put some black eyeshadow in my crease to create the crease. I show it right here, but you can't. I didn't show the color. It's the darkest shade in the palette, so yeah. Then I'm gonna start to carve it out. I'm gonna create my cut crease using my NYX concealer again, like always, and yeah. I'm taking this glittery, shimmery shade from the palette and I'm gonna put that all over my lid. I love this color. You can't really show it. It doesn't show much on camera because I'm sorry, my dumbass didn't focus it correctly, but yeah. I'm creating my wing and I'm using my NYC liquid liner in black because, you know, I'm broke and ain't nobody trying to go to Sephora. I'm gonna be using my two favorite concealers at the moment, which is the L'Oreal Pearl Infallible Matte Foundation and the Revlon Colorstay Foundation. I mix these two colors together, which is 105 and Golden Caramel, and it gives me the perfect shade. By the way, I do use a sponge to apply my foundation because I just find it that it applies way better than a brush. I just recently learned that. I'm going to be setting that with my Rimmel Stay Matte Powder again, so my makeup stays in place all day. I'm going to be using my favorite concealer, which is the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NC25, and I'm going to start to highlight my face. And then I'm using my beauty blender to blend that out. I'm using my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Toffee to contour my face. I feel like this color is a little too light, but you know what? At the moment when I bought it, I was pale as shit, so yeah. It all works out in the end, it's okay. I'm going to be using my Anastasia Contour Kit in Light to Medium. I'm going to be using the darkest shade in the palette to contour with. This is an oldie but a goodie. I'm going to be blending it out. I don't want it to be so harsh on my face. Next, I'm using the Too Faced Flush Blush, whatever, in the color Your Love is King, and I'm using that with an e.l.f. powder brush, I think it's called. Yeah. Then, of course, I'm taking all the colors that I took and put in my crease. I'm putting that under my lower lash line so it can look all even and beautiful. I'm going to be taking my favorite highlighting kit, bitch. The Anastasia Beverly Hills Sunday Glow Kit. I love it. And I'm going to just highlight my face to look like a glowing machine. Yes. Then I'm taking the ColourPop Matte Liquid Lipstick in the color R&B. One thing about the ColourPop Liquid Lipsticks, I like them, but they do dry so much. Like, if you're trying to have the Sahara Desert on your lips, then use the ColourPop one. But yeah, I made it work. And that is the completed look. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. And yeah, if you like it, please like, subscribe, and share. Let me know if you want to see any upcoming videos, if you want to see holiday tutorials, if you want to see New Year's tutorials, if you want to just see tutorials in general, or hauls, or more try-on clothing hauls, or whatever. Just let me know and I will be happy to do them for you. I love you guys and thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Mwah! Bye!